Private keys, digital signatures, transactions, connecting to a blockchain node, there are a lot of concepts users need to learn to interact with a blockchain. Or do they? In the early days of the internet, it was an intimidating place for many average users with concepts such as HTTP, IP, and HTML. Web browsers then came along and abstracted away most of those details, while providing an easy-to-use interface for users. Web browsers made interacting with the internet more accessible, and crypto wallets make interacting with blockchains more accessible. But what exactly are crypto wallets? Let's dive right in. Crypto wallets generate and store private public key pairs and use them to interact with a blockchain. They interact with blockchains by generating properly encoded transactions. I'll cover transactions in a future video. Crypto wallets are non-custodial, meaning users retain complete control of key pairs. Opposing non-custodial wallets are custodial services that hold users' keys for them, such as an exchange like Coinbase. Crypto wallets handle generating randomness and utilizing any cryptography necessary for generating key pairs. Upon setup, wallets will typically provide the user with a random secret phrase. You can use the secret phrase to recover all private public key pairs within the wallet. Crypto wallets use private keys to sign transactions and public keys to derive an address that represents a user on the blockchain. Wallets typically generate addresses by taking the hash of a public key. For example, in Ethereum wallets, the address is generated by hashing the public key with the Ketchak 256 algorithm and taking the last 20 bytes. There are two main types of crypto wallets: software wallets and hardware wallets. There are also smart contract wallets, but we'll cover those in a future video. Software crypto wallets can be downloaded to most devices such as laptops and smartphones. Some of the most popular software wallets are extensions that can be added to a web browser, such as MetaMask. In addition to generating and sending transactions, software wallets also show relevant blockchain info such as derived addresses, cryptocurrency held, and past transactions sent to a blockchain. Software wallets also provide a convenient UI for users to create transactions by filling out easy-to-understand fields such as to and amount. Software wallets typically use passwords or passcodes to encrypt private keys. The primary advantage of software wallets is that users can conveniently access their wallets from whatever device they may already be using. The primary disadvantage is that private keys are on a computer with a greater attack surface than a hardware wallet. The computer may also remain online even when the user is not sending blockchain transactions. Popular software wallets include MetaMask and Electrum. Hardware wallets are physical devices explicitly designed to act as highly secure crypto wallets. They typically have a screen and buttons which act as an interface. The generation and signing of transactions occur solely within the hardware wallets themselves. You can then connect hardware wallets to a computer, typically via USB, to send the signed transactions to a blockchain. Sending transactions is handled by a separate software downloaded to the computer, often a software wallet. Even when using a software wallet as an interface to send transactions, all hardware wallets' private keys are kept on the hardware wallet. The primary advantage of using hardware wallets is the increased security of isolating the generated private keys. Having a separate device that stores private keys and remains offline until sending a transaction greatly reduces the attack surface. The primary disadvantages are that users must take extra care of physically securing the wallet, and they can be less convenient than software wallets. Examples of popular hardware wallet companies are Ledger and Trezor. In summary, wallets abstract away the details of generating key pairs and signed transactions from users. They are the main way most people will interact with the blockchain. The two main types of wallets are hardware and software, which offer trade-offs between convenience and security. Keep an eye out for a future video on adequately securing your wallet. It is an essential subject. Just like crypto wallets abstract away interacting with the blockchain, these videos abstract away researching the basics of blockchains. With that, this video on crypto wallets is complete, so I'll hash you in the next block.